as we begin this slideshow, the second in a series, which ultimately will show images of our community at their households being blessed by Jesus in the Eucharist, allow me to open with a few words while you see a few images of St. Peter's in Vatican City during this pandemic. The pictures from the Vatican are a bit eerie as the square and basilica show an unusual emptiness, but they are not devoid of hope as Pope Francis reminds us that Christ is present and is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Enjoy while I just say a few words to our community. Brothers and sisters, welcome to week 8 of our stay-at-home advisory during this coronavirus pandemic. It is still the Easter season. Among these 50 days of Easter, today is traditionally called Good Shepherd Sunday. If things were normal, our parish would be having its pancake breakfast today as a fundraiser for a youth mission trip that would have been taking place at the end of June. And our religious education students would be participating in what we call a moving up ceremony, where they would be bringing an end to this year's classes and meeting their teachers for next year. Also, our First Communion students would be having their final practices for the big day when they would receive Jesus for the first time in the Eucharist. That would have been 2 weeks from now. Of course, as you know so well, the coronavirus pandemic has postponed things for now. The children and young people will come, and all our people will come. With the grace of God, I hope soon. But we have an extended time to think now about the deeper meaning of the sacraments, the deeper meaning of what it means to come together as church, to come together as a community, to worship together as one body in Christ. Though we are many parts, we are one body in Christ. It is time again to see members of our community receiving the Eucharistic blessing of Jesus. As I said, this is our second slideshow. We will have more. Our people long to receive Jesus in the Eucharist. Therefore, in the present moment, when we have not been able to give Holy Communion, I have decided to bring Jesus in a Eucharistic blessing to our community's households. I was deeply touched and encouraged once again by the faithful response of the people. One moment particularly moving was when an ambulance driver, an EMT, probably waiting to pick up another COVID-19 resident from the nursing home across from one of our parishioners' homes, asked me to bless him and his ambulance. He wanted to have Christ with him. Take a moment now to look at our photos, and I'll say a few words at the end.
How beautiful the hands that served the wine and the bread and the sons of the earth. How beautiful the feet that walked the long dusty roads and the hill to the cross. How beautiful, how beautiful, how beautiful is the body. How beautiful, how beautiful, how beautiful. deliver me, O God, from the need to be understood, and from a need to be accepted, from the fear of from the fear of serving others, oh, and from the fear of death or trial, and from the fear of humility,
is found is where you are.
My brothers and sisters, this concludes our second slideshow. Forgive me if it was a little bit long, but we don't want to leave anybody out. May God continue to bless you and love you during these days. Let us together spread a contagion of hope, for Jesus Christ is my living hope. God bless you.